Hi guys, so you guys know who I am, some of you may not, but my name is Demetria and I'm coming with you guys with another tutorial video. It's actually a contest or challenge with the Juvias Place PR team, because you know we're stuck in quarantine and there's really not much for us to do. So they're doing a challenge to wear it in, like you use like the Juvia's Place complexion products as far as like the foundation, the powders and etc., concealers and stuff like that. They want us to create like the most like glowy, most kind of, to me, what I got from the email, to me, if I felt like it was more towards like a natural glow look, makeup look. So first I'm going to start off with the Bioderma Marcella water. I can never pronounce that word right. So I'm going to be using this. Hope you guys can see it. So I'm just gonna just wipe. And then I'm going to go and use the, I think it's Kiehl's Ultra. I got a little test on if y'all can see that. Or a little sample. You know, Sephora, dude. You spend like $1 million and they give you shit like this. Because I don't want my video to be too long. Go in and with the Touch and Soul. I love for this stuff. So I'm gonna go in with the Benefit Brow and Precisely, and this is in number 5. I'm just doing like hair-like strokes in my brows. Nothing like too dramatic. I'm just gonna go and where's that powder? It was this powder that I got as Savarna's. So what this came from, it came from my eyebrow threading place a while ago that I used to get my brows done in Virginia. It's on Alaskan Road. So I go back in and do like little like hair-like strokes to go over top of it. So that way it doesn't look too brown. And this is like a dark brown. So it looks damn near black, but not. Oh shit. That's the natural they gonna look. So I think I'm gonna cover my eye with Lancome Tonti Doll. I like to use this on my lid. Kind of gives me like a nice little soft matte effect. Just might leave it like this and call it a day. I might set it with some powder actually, let me not lie. I'm actually gonna go in with, sorry, with the Juvia's Place Warrior Palette. I'm gonna take I can get this shit open. I'm gonna take this color here and just put it all over the lid just to set it. All right, so I got some stuff that was sent for me from Coastal Scents. So I'm gonna use this, some of the stuff I did pick out. I just randomly pick stuff, they let you pick your stuff out. So I was like, oh, let me try this. It's a nice little travel thing. So they got some travel brushes in here. So I'll probably go ahead and use this little fluffy one and kind of brush it all over the lid with this powder stuff. This powder stuff with this eyeshadow. So I'm going, oh, the color is up there. It's Kano. I hope that's what it says. So I'm gonna take Mino in here and the Warrior Palette still, and I'm just gonna try to do like a little liner, nothing dramatic, because I don't like doing liners because I'm not good at it. So I just wanna do it to kind of like go close to the, go close to my line, to my lash line, to kind of hide the, I think I made that go up a little higher than I wanted, to kind of hide the lash line. That wasn't that bad. To me, they actually look like it popped it a little bit. Is it just me? Just by me putting a little liner, it looked like it kind of popped it out a little bit. For now. Okay, I'm looking for lashes. So I'm going to use the Kiss Lashes. I don't know if y'all can see that. It's in Daisy. I love these lashes because they look really natural and they look, they're really natural looking and they give volume at the same time. And this lash tool I'm using is from Ulta. I think it's only $10 or $9. So I'm going to go in with the Pat McGrath. This is new, her new concealer. I did receive this in influencer box. I got D30. It's technically a little too dark and a little too orange a little bit. So instead of me like reaching out to them and doing all this extra stuff to try to get the shade that might be mine, which I don't even know because I thought the D30 was, I'm not sure. So I use it as a corrector. And it seems so far to work. Up here, trying to show off. You see how that's a little dark? Is it? Look how much coverage they give me though. Like you see how the undertone's a bit orange? Which is weird because it says, I don't know if you can see it, but me looking at it, it's orange. But you see how it's a little too... So I'm just blending on my finger, warming the product up. Damn, do y'all see that? You got rid of my discoloration. And I'm gonna use the two sticks, complexion sticks from Juvias Place. I got Guinea and Abidjan. I could be saying this wrong, but it's Abidjan, excuse me. And I'm gonna mix these two because these two look really good mixed together. Oh God, please don't make it look like a big orange spot. Actually, and I'm gonna take my sponge. So I'm gonna actually do this. I hope it does not make me look orange, y'all. Like I said, it's easier to work with freaking liquid foundations when it comes to like mixing. I didn't want to use the liquid. I wanted to use the sticks today because I like the sticks better. And this is the Joko company sponge, and I'm going to grab one. If it do come up a little orange, that's okay. I'll kind of like work with it. So I'm going in with the other one. Because using the other one on its own. I'm gonna go in with the Oldie But Goodies, the Coverfx. I need to catch these on sale because they're on, I think it's clearance because they're not on the Sephora website anymore. And before they went away, they were on sale for $24, which was half off. So I don't know if they just continue them or what. But I like them. I don't know why they're doing that. So I have the end deep. I'm going to take the number one shade, which is this highlighting shade. It's a cream. All these are creams. That's what I like about this palette. That's why I'm mad that they're getting rid of it or whatever. But it's in 60s, which is number one. So I'm just going to swirl. It look bright as hell, y'all. It do. But I promise you it's not that bad. I want you to blend it in. I'll probably go back in and soft finishing powder. So I think if the last time I checked this brings back somewhere to my face, so we're going to use some of this. Go ahead, I'm going to start. I'm going to take Katsina. Sorry, y'all. So I try to blend it in with my hairline so that way it's not looking not unnatural. Mm-hmm. I don't have no lashes, y'all. This is crazy. And this is the Pavagrow powder. So that'll brighten me up just a little bit, just a little bit. I'm just gonna go under my eye with the Kano that I put all over the lid, under the eye, just to put something underneath there. So, like I said, I did get sent some things from Coastal Scents. I was able to pick this out. I was curious about this for the longest, so I'm going to use a blush out of here. This thing is huge, y'all. So, makeup artists, I don't know if y'all want to use this in your... I mean, not saying don't use it, but you're probably not deep potting it. So, because this thing is big. So, I think I might first go in with this really light rosy pink first and see what that looks like. I feel like I'm oxidizing. Everything's gonna make me back up. Then I'm using that same complexion brush. I'm using it for everything. I'm trying to minimize me using a bunch of brushes. Let me put some of that. There we go. Sitting in my seat, head to put the bus. If I didn't shoot first. So I'm gonna go in with her Mannerisms Florence and liquid highlighter. And I got in Drip Bronze. They sent these to me a while ago. Learned this tip. What's her name? Jewel. I'm so sorry, but she owns OM Glow Cosmetics. She owns like glow sprays. And I seen her do this, and she went like this. So let me see if that will work for me. Let's see. I got stuff all on my hand. I'm sorry if I said your name wrong, boo. I'm gonna tag you in the video. I'm like, girl, I think I butchered your name. But yeah, she owns OM. I keep wanting to say OMG, but it's OM Glow. Because sometimes it's kind of hard to work with creams on your own face or liquids. So this is a nice little tip that I learned from her. I literally just watched the video, I think like last night. So I'm gonna take this, actually is an eyeliner. It's by Appeal Cosmetics. It's my favorite. I got this in a box, BoxyCharm too. I was so glad I actually got this. It's actually a liner, but this is my favorite lip liner. I use it as a lip liner, and I need to buy more of these because I need some backups. Cause these are bomb. This is the best, my favorite brown lip liner. I used to really be hooked to chestnut until I got this and I tried it. I went, oh, chestnut. I'm sorry, I don't have to replace you, baby. I picked out lip gloss too from Coastal Scents too as well. So, and it's an amethyst. I'm gonna go ahead and give it a whirl. Give it a try. Hopefully it doesn't give me too much of a pigment. But typically pink is like my new color. So we'll see how this looks. And if I don't like it, then I will switch off and go with a clear lip gloss. But this one looks like it may be okay. It's got glitter in there. So putting it back in my hand. Let's see. I might put some more too. It's essence. Actually, I typically order like 3 or 4 or 5 at a time. And they think they slick because they went up a little bit too on these glosses. You can get them from essence.com or ulta.com. So for a little extra gloss. Oh, this is pretty. A very nude, my skin, to me this is my, this is skin. Skin is in. Oh shit. Let me see, I might want to put a bit more. And this is mine, so I don't use this on clients, so I can do this. Might still like sanitize it off though. Let's go back and down. You know, go ahead and do the Morphe Continuous spray. And I'm gonna go ahead and press it in. I don't wanna press too much, huh? So I just decided to throw on a cute little scarf. I got it from one, like, you know, the little Chinese hair stores or whatever. So I thought it was cute. Gives me like a nice little pretty, you know, island feel or whatever. So this is my my skin is in challenge. To me, it just looks like my face is just super hydrated. It to me looks even, I guess. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, my neck, my face, my neck, and my body are 3 different colors. Just FYI. So I got this this skin infused from 24K Skin. She sent me some products a little while back, so thought about maybe putting some on. Oh, my battery does not go there, y'all. I'm sorry if it does. So let me get my mirror because I don't see what I'm doing. So we're just gonna see if it'll give me like a. Be looking weird, like your body be dry as hell, but then your face is like glowing. It's like you might want to put a little bit of glow on your body. Ooh. That made me look a little bronze, right? Now it looks like everything's coming together. Like I said, even though like my neck is dark, my neck is the darkest thing on my body. And no, I don't have diabetes or anything like that. It's just probably just need losing that weight. But anyway, that's probably what it is. I need to lose some more weight, but I haven't lost the weight though. It's baby steps. Ooh, I like that 24K girl. I'ma tag you in this girl. So wish me luck, guys. Hopefully I do one of the contestants to win this food. That'll be great. That'll be awesome. So this video should be coming out soon. I want to post it definitely way before Friday, because Friday is supposed to pick the winner, so it's gonna be up. By Wednesday night or tonight, I don't know. You're gonna see definitely done by Friday though. So yeah, this is my final look, guys. Hope you guys like it. You guys can like, share, and all that good old stuff and whatnot. And I'll see you in my next video.